Let us now calculate the magnetic induction due to a circular coil at its center. Here, as we have discussed, by using right hand thumb rule, we can find out the magnetic induction at the center of a coil. Here, it is carrying a current in clockwise direction. So, if I curl my fingers along the clockwise direction, my thumb will point in inward direction. So, at center or at every interior point in its plane, magnetic induction will be in inward direction. To find out the magnetic induction at point O, the center of this coil, I use Bio-Savart's law. I consider an element of length dl on this coil, and due to element dl, if magnetic induction at O is dB, then this dB can be given by Bio-Savart's law as mu naught upon 4 pi I dl sine theta, the angle which the position of this point O with the element dl is 90 degree. So, sine 90 can be taken as 1 divided by r square. So, net magnetic induction at point O we can write as integration of dB. This integration of mu naught upon 4 pi I dl by r square, and limits for dl along the length of this coil we write as 0 to 2 pi r for one turn of the coil. So here magnetic induction at point O we can write as mu naught I by 4 pi r square, which is a constant we can take out of the integral sign. This integration of dl from 0 to 2 pi r, which we are getting mu naught I by 4 pi r square multiplied by integration of dl from 0 to 2 pi r is 2 pi r. Here pi gets cancelled out, r also gets cancelled out, 2 will also be cancelled. So magnetic induction at point O we can write as mu naught I by 2 r. That is the result of magnetic induction at point O. This is for one turn of the coil. And we can say if there are n turns in coil, this magnetic induction at point O we can write as mu naught I by 2r multiplied by n, which can be written as mu naught I n by 2r. That is the magnetic induction due to n turns of the coil. So be careful about the result that is going to be used in many different applications.